All right, so tape saturation is more of a preference thing. It really gives you that beefy analog tone. And when I was shopping for a channel strip, I looked at Solid State Logic and I looked at API. I think Rupert Neve Designs had the best saturation circuitry. So some people would ask, why do you want a tape sound on a modern digital recording? In my opinion, I think a lot of the modern recordings sound a little too stale to me, sound a little too crisp and kind of fake. To me, that's just my opinion. And I think the tape saturation gives you that vintage, deep analog tone that we like to hear. I grew up listening to a lot of 60s and 70s rock music, so that's kind of where my ear is at. So this is the 542 tape emulator. This is a real special module, gives you that beefy analog tone. This is called Silk Red, gives you a high mid, which I don't use because I have over here already on the preamp. Silk Blue gives you a low mid. I use both Silk Red and Blue for every track, but I'll turn it off for now just so it doesn't glare to the camera. This switch emulates the speed of the tape, so 30 IPS I use for everything. It's good for vocals and acoustic guitar and cymbals and everything. You push it out, it's 15 IPS. That's supposed to be like a slower tape, and that's good for bass, the kick, the snare. You can use it on guitar to get like a deep Marshall grit sound, but I like the 30 IPS. So there's supposed to be a real tape head inside of this. So it's one of those things where you have to apply it to a full mix to really hear what it's doing. I have a few videos on YouTube where you can hear what it's doing to a whole mix. One in particular, I did my own version of Soul Sacrifice, and I really saturated the drums quite a bit. So the way that I have this channel strip set up, I have the preamp going into the tape emulator, and then into the compressor, I have a cable in the back. Then I have another cable going from the compressor to the equalizer. I always put the equalizer last. Some people put the compressor last. I did try to put the tape emulation at the end of the channel strip, but it gave me way too much low end. I called the pro audio of my local guitar center about this equipment, and they didn't know what I was talking about, so I ended up buying everything through Sweetwater. The only weak link in my setup is I have a Focusrite Scarlett interface, so I'm not getting the real professional sound that I want. I'm hoping next year to upgrade to maybe an Antelope or something more professional. So anyways, that's about it.